and Assalamualaikum everyone. My name is SITI SYAHIRAH BINTI SAAD. I am a Form 5 student at SMK Tanjung Gemuk. I was a science stream student there. Today, I am going to tell you about my life at home during the movement control order. As we all know, the government has issued a movement control order in an effort to curb the spread of COVID-19 virus. As a student, the most important thing after the MCO started is the study process. This is especially important for students who will take exams like icseR, PT3, SPM, and STPM. They will be worried because the exam will be around the corner, but they are unable to attend school. To be honest, I was not really affected when the government announced that the MCO was implemented from March 18 to March 31st. I believe that it will be over soon. However, when the government extended the MCO to April 15, I started to panic. This is because I am still unable to adapt to online learning method. I began to feel pressured and worried about my learning. I believe that every student can relate to this. From then on, I started to take this matter seriously. I started to ask my friends about lessons, and I also became active in online classes. For your information, my teachers use a variety of online applications to teach. These include Google Meet, Google Classroom, Telegram, and WhatsApp application. There are also teachers who use Facebook Live to teach. After using this app several times, I've been able to master how to use it. I find that online classes are fine and can encourage students to learn while at home. However, I do not deny that there are some barriers to running an online class. For example, those students who live in the interior may not have internet access, so they may not be able to attend the class. As for me, I am lucky because I still haven't had any problem attending an online class. If I was asked if I wanted to take an online class or go to school as usual, I would definitely choose to go to school as usual. I am very grateful that the MCO have been entering the recovery phase, which means the school is about to be open. I would like to thank all the frontliners who have been working very hard for this about 3 months in order to provide protection to us from this COVID-19 virus. I hope that all of us can stay safe, and please remember that it is our responsibility to take care of ourselves.